Archaeologists of Reddit. What are some latest discoveries that the masses have no idea of? In my hometown of Lübeck in northern Germany, they found a latrine from the Middle Age and analyzed the genes of the tapeworms in it or something, and apparently that dude that took a sh there has once also taken a sh in England, cause his DNA has been found in tapeworms there as well. This is more biological and throw archaeology, but recently a jawbone of Dinosaur 7 remains was found in Tibet, which is crazy since those are super difficult living conditions. Even in today's lifetime. So far the other remains have been found in Siberia. Denisovans have only come up in conversation and discovery quite recently, so it's always crazy to find any sort of remains. Really gives an idea to our development and what we might have evolved from. Archaeologists recently discovered a hidden chamber in Roman Emperor Nero's underground palace. Recently a ton of phenomenal finds have been excavated in Britain. Examples being a preserved Iron Age shield found in Leicestershire, which changes how we perceive Iron Age British tribal equipment in combat. Hoping it will open the door to a broader understanding of the military capabilities of this period. And that C14 dating will give us a more specific dating assessment. I've mainly worked in classical Greek and Imperial Roman archaeology, and Vindolanda is one such site which has been pumping out phenomenal research and artifact findings. Being a reasonably well-preserved Roman fort along Hadrian's Wall. Artifacts are found daily. During the past couple of weeks, finds have ranged from leather shoes, tent canvas, even bathhouse sandals to prevent you burning your feet on the hot tiles. These finds have opened a window of immense understanding of daily life within a Roman defensive fort. Not an archaeologist, but they are using LiDAR to uncover more buried temples all over the world. The ones that intrigue me are in South America and Cambodia at Angkor Wat. It's at the museum I work at right now. It's a mammoth bone that the museum is claiming has human processing marks. They refuse to let other anthropologists look at it to really examine the marks. So I am calling BS, or at least I'm skeptical. I got to look at it very briefly along with some other anthropologists. But then the museum stops everyone. It has everyone pretty split. It was found in San Diego, and if this was to be true, it would rewrite everything about human migration we know. This is not a small museum. This is a public museum, not religiously affiliated, that is making a large claim. A lot of infighting RN. I'm an archaeologist who mostly works in the private sector. We find a lot of cool stuff. But almost everything we do is classified to some degree or another to discourage pot hunters and vandalism. This year I found an extension of a really important late woodland, the period right before Europeans arrived in America, site. And worked on a very cool 19th century burial ground that had been partially destroyed out of negligence by a construction company. Which is a big problem we run into. Both sites were super cool. But I can't get into specifics about where they're located. The remains of the last slave ship to smuggle imported slaves into America. After it was outlawed. Was just found in Alabama. I don't know a lot about it because I'm not an underwater archaeologist. Though discovered quite a few years back, Göbekli Tepe only recently escaped the controversy of its significance. Now widely considered to quite possibly be the first temple of worship, the site has caused a rethinking of early humankind's spiritual practices. To give you an idea, Göbekli Tepe is estimated to be 6 millennia older than Stonehenge. Okay, I've got another one related to my actual degree, Egyptology. The tomb of Nethotep was discovered in the early 1900s. But it was badly damaged, and therefore we're still investigating all the material we have. A lot of it was burned by tomb robbers, but there is still some epigraphic evidence. One of the most interesting pieces is a tiny piece of pottery with a serek on it. The symbol of the name of the king. For context, Nethotep was from pre-dynastic Egypt. Just before the first dynasty. And this is where it gets exciting. Nethotep is believed to be the mother of the first pharaoh of Egypt. However, on this piece of pottery, her name is written in a serek, indicating she was a pharaoh. Of course, it's possible that it was just indicating her as queen. But it's quite fun to think that there's a very good chance the first pharaoh of Egypt was a woman. Furthermore, as far as we can tell, this is the earliest ever surviving evidence of a woman's name written down. We all thought that was pretty cool. Not really that major, but last year I did field school in North Jersey at a Revolutionary War encampment and we found a button, like a jacket button, that had USA written on it. It was really interesting to see the use of that acronym from such an early stage in America's infancy. Everybody in the field school was freaking out about it. I don't know if it's national news or anything, but a bunch of fossils and bones of some sort of hornet dino were just found on a construction site in Highlands Ranch, Colorado. My cousin's boyfriend was one of the workers that found them. Some dick on his team was trying to load his truck up with a bunch of the fossils and bones and destroyed them. The museum had to confiscate stuff from him. But it's still pretty cool that Colorado has another dinosaur. I think we've had another dinosaur and another really good set of fossils found here. Also, I know this is paleontology and not archaeology, but it's still cool. And I wasn't thinking about that when I decided to post. Not sure how far it got in news-wise, but while renovating the Canadian Parliament in Ottawa, they found a military base older than Confederation. It housed the soldiers building the Rideau Canal. I think it was date 1820. The lead guy was super excited cause they just found where the latrine was. And you can hide things in there easily. I'm surprised at the mass amount of people that haven't heard of the lunar settlement in Pensacola, FL. It was the first European multi-year settlement in the country and dates to 1559. The story is tragic and we have the unique opportunity to not only investigate the land settlement, but also the shipwrecks right off the coast. Additionally, I am working on a Native American site across the bay this summer. We are trying to see if natives were present during Luna's time here, because it appears that the natives just peaced out when they saw his ships rolling up through the bay. Which may explain why they didn't help him and his company. Very cool history here. Highly recommend looking it up. Not an archaeologist, but a major in paleontology. A well-preserved T-Rex skeleton has been discovered in Saskatchewan. They named the new world's largest and oldest T-Rex skeleton. I have always loved dinosaurs. Sorry that it doesn't fully relate to the Reddit question. Archaeologist here. Just got out of the field at a site that may have been a native person in Virginia who was once enslaved and had their freedom restored in 1699. The public doesn't hear that much about native people in the English colonies being enslaved, because the Atlantic slave trade really took hold in the late 17th century. But there are a number of accounts going well into the 18th century. Not an archaeologist and was not really hidden, but near me. In 2017, a guy found a huge unexploded bomb from WW2, which he dug out with construction machines and took pictures. Drove it around and whatnot. It had a 20-kilometer blast radius, so it would be pretty dangerous. Had it exploded. Made big news back in the summer of 17 in Slovenia, lol. It was a 230 kilogram bomb. They evacuated a 1 kilometer radius.